Rainbow robot, blah.
Our final advanced solar generator. Okay, so these should be quite impressive. Yep, they stick up quite a ways. Should I have one more? There we go. There they are. Does it work now? Yes, it works. It is generating power. So now we need to feed some water into it. I didn't bring any pipes. Well, while we're here, we'll torch up the place. Whoa. Oh, you can't put torches on top of microblock fences. Interesting. did the pump go? Did I not pick up the pump? I might not have picked up the pump. No pump. Where did you go to? I don't see it here. Pump. I do not see any pumps anywhere. That kind of sucks. Okay, how you doing? Oh, you're full of energy. That's good. Slowly going down now that it's nighttime. So I have a present for you. Where should I leave it?
In one of my chests is fine.
Leaving it in the one with your elementium armor.
Okay.
All right, a pump. Saw somewhere that I might need to make this to set this up to push in. I don't think I've ever had to do before, but that seems to be working. Now there's water going in. But let's see what we've got here. Hey, that water's already turned into brine! It looks like it turns one bucket of water into a tenth of a bucket of brine. And now that we've got that much working, we want to make a chunk loader. So we'll always be making brine. Pearl on top, gold around, enchant table on the bottom, gives us a chunk loader. Excellent. Ought to be plenty. And now it will run while we continue to make the rest of the machines. So, machines that I need to make. What I want to end up with is shards, I believe? Yes, shards. And in order to make shards, I need a chemical injection chamber and salt or hydrogen chloride. Now, hydrogen chloride you get by combining hydrogen and chlorine. And hydrogen, let's see, chlorine you get from liquid chlorine or from separating brine into sodium and chlorine in an electrolytic separator. However, I believe you can also just make salt directly. Let's see here. So I think I will start by making salt. And you make salt from gaseous brine, which you make from brine in a rotary condensator. So I need to make a rotary condensator. And a chemical crystallizer to make the salt. Concentrator requires glass, a portable tank. I just gained one of those, that's rather convenient. An energy tablet, two basic control circuits, and a gas tank. A gas tank is osmium surrounding iron dust. And I don't have any iron dust here, so I'm going to have to go get my iron dust.
I have now successfully sorted all of my saplings.
Cool.
I can now begin to crossbreed them in an intelligent way.
Yay! To make a gas tank. There we go. Okay, so then we have a portable tank, then we need to make an energy tablet, which we need gold for. 3 gold. There we go, an energy tablet, gas tank, portable tank, and stain and glass, regular glass, which we have some over here. And what else? 2 control circuits. And there we have a rotary condensator. Chemical crystallizer. For that, we need atomic alloy. Atomic alloy is made from reinforced alloy, which is made from enriched alloy. Fortunately, we have some enriched alloys. Okay, so we're going to make some atomic alloy. And first we need to enrich this obsidian. Then we need to enrich this diamond. To change one of these obsidian dust into enriched obsidian dust. Why not make it 2? Refined obsidian dust, yeah. Okay, and then change these enriched alloys into whatever the heck the next step is called. While we enrichment chamber one of these refined obsidian dusts. Okay, there we go. And these are turning into reinforced alloy. Excellent. I want to actually make some of everything, so let's go back and get one more diamond. Okay, there we go. We've got some reinforced alloy. And then we will turn that into atomic alloy. Gas tanks. 1, 2. Another thing we need is a steel casing. To get steel for. There's some steel. Steel casing. That's weird. There we go. Steel casing. Okay, so we take the atomic alloy, place it to the left and the right. Control circuits all around? I think so. Gas tank above, gas tank below, and the steel casing in the middle, and we have a chemical crystallizer. Okay, now we need a power source for all of these, and I believe that our windmill is no longer doing anything. Well, I can see the time has passed here, so that's good. Because it is now night, even though it wasn't when I left. And no monsters have spawned inside the fence. That's excellent. How are we doing here? We are full of brine and filling up with water. Excellent. Okay, so now we want the brine to come out of there. Go into the rotary condensator. Question is, which side of it do we want it to go into? And that is not the right side, because G stands for gas and L stands for liquid. So we want it to go on the other side. Like so. Cool. Then we want a chemical crystallizer to hook up to the gas side. Is that the correct side? Looks like it is the correct side. We won't know until we give them some power, so let's give them some power. Rotary condensator is, however, empty. Why is it empty? Ah, because it is supposed to deconcentrate. There we go, not condensate. Because it will do either. Okay, so the brine is going in, and the gaseous brine is going out, and it's going into the chemical crystallizer. The chemical crystallizer is producing salt. It has already produced one salt. Excellent. Okay, so now we need a way to store this salt. And there, it could produce quite a bit of salt. Let's see if it's keeping up with the solar evaporator. It seems to be keeping up with the solar evaporator. Right now, the problem seems to be the pump is not keeping up with the solar evaporator. I'll make another redstone engine to run the pump, and I will also make a new deep storage unit to store the salt. To do that, I'm going to need these alloys that I've been making. First, we need to make these circuits. There's the thing. Chemical injection chamber, there you go. So we need elite control circuits. So we need two of them, okay? And they are made by taking basic control circuits, two of them, surrounding them with enriched alloys to make advanced control circuits, and surrounding those with reinforced alloy to make elite control circuits. There we go. We also need, where did the thing go again? Alright, we also need two gold, and a purification chamber, which requires, this is going to take a little while. There we go. Now we have a purification chamber. To that we add gold. Two gold ingots. There we go. And the four remaining reinforced alloys. And there we have a chemical injection chamber. Auto-eject. Is it working? Yes! Okay, so the salt is now being stored in the deep storage unit. Okay, so then we take stuff out of the deep storage unit and place it in the chemical injection chamber. Okay, so this is the chemical injection chamber. Hello. Okay. So it is currently not connected. So the purple is where we want the salt to go. So we want to set the left-hand side to purple. There we go. And then we want to set this to output. Okay, and the salt is going in there, and it's making hydrogen chloride very, very slowly. But we kind of knew that this would happen very, very slowly. So we're going to leave it run all week and see if we get enough hydrogen chloride to do anything useful with. We need to give it power as well. In order to do that, we need more basic universal cable along here. This is all very backwards, but it is starting to fill up with power. Yay! So it looks like this could still run faster. You could still give it more water. Well, we'll take care of that next time. Have you looked at your gift yet?
I have not. Honey drum?
Yep.
That's a lot of honey.
Yep. That's two and a half pools worth of honey.
Wow.
Hopefully that's
Thank
all the honey
you.
You'll ever need. Hopefully.
Hopefully.
Bye for now.
Bye for now.
Warning, warning, this video is almost over. Warning, warning, it's time to choose another one. This has gone on far too long, time to wake up and sing along. Warning, warning, this video is over now.